Good afternoon. This is Prophetess Tammy Collins, and I'm back today. I will be discussing a topic the Lord put in my spirit. It's a vital topic. It's one that we really take and put in perspective and really prepare ourselves for what's to come and assess our lives. The topic the Lord has given me today will be tried by tribulation. And this is a sort of prophetic teaching today, and it's also a reflection on the tribulations that the church and the believers are experiencing as I speak, and the coming tribulations that are going to affect mankind and the church. Okay, I'm going to start off a brief prayer, and I'm going to get right into this teaching. You know, it's a vital teaching the Lord has given me to just, you know, display to you today. As I usually upload, I didn't plan on speaking on this, but this is something that's getting ready to shape the church as well as mankind. The things that are getting ready to take place, there's getting ready to be a change in our system, in the religious system, and everything. So whatever you're going through, it is to prepare you, to strengthen you, to endure, because there's going to be more to endure that's coming. Okay, let's pray, and then we're going to get right into the teachings today. Father God, I come before you in the name of Jesus. Thank you for this lesson. It's a vital lesson. It's a prophetic lesson. And I just want to say, I'm honored to be used by you. Let those who have ears to hear and eyes to see, let this teaching bless their heart. Cover them by the blood in their comings and going. Strengthen the church, Lord, even as I speak today. In the name of Jesus, bless the works of their hands. Provide for them supernaturally for their families. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I pray. Amen. Okay. Like I mentioned, I don't really sit around and plot what I'm going to say. I like to be open to be used by the Holy Spirit. And this is what he's given me to teach on, tried by tribulation. Many of us are in the fire. We're being seasoned to walk in what God has ordained for us to walk in, is to prepare us for what's coming so we can also be used for his kingdom and be a blessing for others and to prepare others for what is getting ready to come up on this earth. Okay? Highlight scripture today is 1 Corinthians 10:13, which reads as New Testament. No temptation has overtaken you except what is common to mankind. And God is faithful. He will not let you be tempted beyond what you can bear. But when you are tempted, he will also provide a way out so that you can endure it. This is a scripture that's speaking to each and every one of us right now. This 1 Corinthians 10:13 is what we're walking through as the body of Christ believers right now. We have to trust that God is going to get us out of the fire and get us where he's leading us, because a lot of us are going to be, I'm speaking prophetically, used for what's getting ready to come up on this earth. And I say this because our religious system, government system, the new world order, all that is getting ready to kick in. And we must prepare our spirits, our families, our communities to be strengthened and to adjust, because our nation is getting ready to take a turn. People say that we're going to go back to what things were. I'm sorry. We're not going back. We're in the end times. Prophecy is kicking in. So we must prepare ourselves, our hearts, minds, souls, and spirits for what's coming up on the earth. I mean, we're in Revelations. So, you know, a lot of things are going to be taking place. They're going to be mind-boggling, mind-blowing. A lot of people won't make it because they won't be able to endure the tests and the trials that are going to happen. Okay, let's do the synopsis and then get right to the scriptures. As we go through our personal trials and tribulations in this unprecedented time of famine, disease, viruses, and possibly nuclear war upon our planet, Satan is working behind the scenes to set up a new world order. Underworld government. One world religion is the preparation for the Antichrist. And the Lord said, we would have tests and trials and tribulation. As of now, many Christians are completely unprepared. And I'm sorry, the church, they're not ready. A lot of them are just not ready for what's going to happen. You got to understand that this is a prophetic time. This is the end times, and things are going to be changing. You must prepare yourself. Strengthen yourself. Okay? For what the Bible has warned us about, believers must prepare to meet the Lord before the great tribulation, so they will not be left behind to experience the wrath of God upon the wicked and the harsh treatment that believers will experience who are left to face the Antichrist. These things are prophetically written. I don't say these on a planned plot, but they're already prophetically written. Now, get your house in order so you won't be left to go through these, come in through the second tribulation. Because if, you know, once the church is taken out, the second tribulation, there's going to be some church folks left here, religious ones. You know, the church that's within a church is the one who are like the 10 bridesmaids that have prepared themselves. 5 have filled their lamps, 5 did not. Are you among those 5 who have filled their lamps? Meaning, are you filled with the Holy Spirit and God's anointing? So he can identify you as one of his own. When he comes back, when the bridegroom comes back, which is Christ, will you be ready to meet him? Have you gotten your spirit ready? Are you filled with the Holy Spirit? Are you anointed? Are you carrying oil? Or are you dry? Because if you're not carrying oil, I'm sorry. And if you're not filled with the Spirit, you will be left. This is what this parable is talking about. Okay, so let's move forward. Lamentations 4:13. The New Testament, Old Testament, which reads as Lamentation. In the middle of the Bible. For the sins of her prophets and the iniquities of her priests that have shed the blood of the just in the midst of her. This is why God, this is Jeremiah's writing, okay, the Old Testament. This is why God judged the Israelites when he took them through and wiped the kingdom out, looted the kingdoms, had other nations come in and wipe them out, had other nations come in, take over, rob them, loot, rape the women, kill, you know, the prophets. They just took over. And what is getting ready to take place? It's going to be a lot of a wrath, God's wrath. Now, God allowed the Israelites to go through this because of their disobedience, because of the level of sin. And I'm sorry, this country is beyond the measure of sin. We are going to be judged. And this is going to be a judgment from our Lord. Not from the enemy, from our Lord. Okay? He's a holy, just God, and he has to deal with us, and this is what's getting ready to prophetically manifest. Now, he dealt with the old school Israelites because of their disobedience, and the blood that was shed, the prophets, the priests, they were profane, and you know, he got it as a way of dealing with his own. So that's what it's talking about, a lamentation. This was a repercussion of what was dealt with that nation, how God dealt with that nation in that time. What happened with the forefathers of the ancient Israelites. Okay, let's go to 2 Timothy 3:12-13, which reads as, this is the New Testament. Yeah, and all that will live godly in Christ Jesus shall suffer persecution, but evil men and seducers shall wax worse and worse, deceiving and being deceived. This is now. This is taking place now, even as I teach this. This scripture is alive in the church and in the world. I'm going to repeat it. Yeah, all that will live godly in Christ shall suffer persecution. And this is why the closer you get to Christ, you know the devil's going to attack you. The closer you get, he's going to come against you. But stand your grounds. The Lord won't suffer you more than what you're able to bear. But the evil man and seducers shall wax worse and worse, deceiving and being deceived. This is what's happening. That's why you look out in a lot of your communities, the news, it's like people just giving up, they're losing it, you know, because of the sign of the times, what's going on. We're in the end times right now. And it's written, I'm sorry, it's written, it's going to get worse. It's not going to get better. It's not going to get better until our Lord returns. And this is it. And he's going to come for those who are ready to leave. Okay, now, let's keep moving. Lamentations 3, Old Testament 31 to 33, which reads as, "For the Lord will not cast off forever. But though he causes grief, yet will he have compassion according to the multitude of his mercies. For he doeth not afflict willingly, nor grieve the children of men." A lot of the judgments, the persecutions, testing the trials, and the attacks, God's allowing it. And a lot of them are coming from him. Now, this is what happened in Lamentations, written by the hand of Jeremiah, because he walked with God as a prophet, as a major prophet. He saw the repercussion of what happened to his people and his nation in those days. Well, God is going to do the same in our time. He's going to allow the wrath to come up on to correct. When he sends wrath and judgment, it's for correction. Okay, like he said, "But though he causes grief, yet will he have compassion according to the multitude of his mercies. For the Lord will not cast off forever." And when he sends the attacks, allow the enemy to attack, the persecution, the trials and tribulations, it's to correct and to make you stronger and better. He sends the afflicts. A lot of time, it's mostly the Lord doing this. You know, he uses the enemy to do his jobs. The enemy works for him. So if you're going through tribulations and trials right now in your life, assess your life, because the attacks, the tribulation, the trials, it's to test you, it's to prove you, and to prepare you what's coming. It's to strengthen you, okay? So remember, most of the time, it's not coming from the enemy. He uses the enemy, but it's coming from the Lord's hand. But he would not allow you to suffer what you can bear, okay? Only what you can endure, you know, he'll allow. If you're dealing with it, they say this. People have told me this. Well, if you got the problem, if you got it, then you can handle it. Okay? God's not going to put no more on us we can bear. Okay, let's go to the New Testament, which reads as 1 Peter 5:10. 1 Peter 5:10, which reads as, "And after you have suffered a little while, the God of all grace, who has called you into his own eternal glory in Christ, will himself restore, confirm, strengthen, and establish you. After you endure, after you've been tested, after you've been tried through tribulation, our God of all grace will restore you. He will confirm you, approve you, strengthen you, and he will establish you." You got to get through those tests. Now, do your best to get through the tests and the tribulation, because if you don't and you fail it, it's like taking an exam. You're going to have another one. And it'll be a different scene, different people, same test, same trial. Learn the lesson. Endure it. Learn the lesson so you can pass it and go on to the next level of your destiny. Okay? Let's go to Revelations 2 and 10, New Testament, which reads as the last book of the Bible. Revelations 2 and 10, which reads as, "Fear not of those things which thou shalt suffer. Behold, the devil shall cast some of you into prison, that you may be tried, and you shall have the tribulations 10 days. I say this, a lot of Christians have not experienced this. Some have gotten peace, but it's going to amplify. This is Revelations. That's the book. But it's according to the end times. We're in it right now, okay? You shall be, You shall have tribulation 10 days, but thou be faithful unto death, and I will give thee a crown of life. If this happens to the other believers, then keep your mouth shut. Take your place as a saint and be quiet and allow the Lord to speak through you, because it's to try you for 10 days. Not every church saint will go through this, but some will and some have. So remember, we're in the end times, and this is what this is talking about, okay? So let's move forward. Let's get hot here. All right. James, New Testament, the book of James, 1 through 12. James 1, 12. James 1st chapter, 12th verse, which reads as, count it all joy, my brothers, when you meet trials of various kinds. What this verse is saying is, I'm going to be honest, most of us don't act right when we're going through trials. We murmur, we complain, we put up a fuss. But this scripture is telling us, count it all joy, my brothers, when you meet trials and various kinds. It's prepare you for the Lord and his new kingdom as a citizen of heaven. God has proven you to see if you will qualify to be that faithful saint, to be in his kingdom, in his new Jerusalem, when he comes to set up his kingdom on earth. So we are to count it all joy and be thankful that he is trying us to get us ready for to rule and reign with him when he returns. Okay? That's when he sets up his kingdom. Because as you know, he's going to get his believers out that's ready, and then he's going to come back with his, you know, 10,000 saints to deal with the wicked. And then when he sets his kingdom up, it, you know, on earth, you'll be with him in his new kingdom. So count it all a joy when you fall into various kinds of temptations and trials, okay? Tests and trials. Let's go to 1 Peter 4 and 12, which reads as New Testament. Beloved, do not be surprised at the fiery trials when it comes upon you to test you as though something strange were happening in you, like what most of us do. Why is this happening to me? What did I do? And a lot of times you haven't done nothing. The Lord is just testing you to see if you are ready to endure, to go to the next level of your life. If he can count on you to stand the hard situations or a temporary situation, he's testing your character. And a lot of times when he allows these trials and tribulations to come up on his children is to shape us in the image of his son. Remember this, none of us have suffered the type of suffering and trials that Christ went through. So if he's allowing us to deal with it the best way you can, with the best attitude you can, okay? Let's go to Acts 14:22, which reads as New Testament. Strengthening the souls of the disciples, encouraging them to continue in the faith, and saying that though through many tribulations, we must enter the kingdom of heaven, kingdom of God. This is what I'm saying. This is like to prepare you for initiation. This is to prepare you to see if you're ready to be a citizen of his new kingdom. So he takes us through these trials and tribulations to prepare us, because every citizen that's in his kingdom have been tried and tested. And that's what it's saying here. Strengthening the souls of the disciples and encouraging them to continue in the faith, and saying that through many trials, tribulations, we must enter the kingdom of God. He's just not gonna, he'll give you an invitation, but you gotta pay your dues, okay? And that's the past test. The trials and the tribulation and, you know, attacks, you gotta, that's how you get strengthened. That's how he knows if you're really ready to be a part of his kingdom, okay? You got to go through something. Now let's go to Psalms 34:19. Remember, all this is for his glory. It has nothing to do with us. Don't take it personal. Psalms 34:19. Many are the afflicted of the righteous, but the Lord delivers them out of them all. Whatever you may be afflicted with, whatever you may be going through, remember, he's going to deliver you. Don't take it personal. Endure it. It's a test. Be strengthened. It's a lesson. He's going to deliver you, and he's going to pull you out. He doesn't leave his children in situations like that. So remember, whatever you do, you're being tested and tried. To be shaped in the image of his son. To be ready for his kingdom as a citizen. Okay? So, do your best. I know sometimes we complain among us. Give it to God and ask him to strengthen you through whatever you may be in dealing with and enduring. You won't stay in it forever. Okay? I hope I was a blessing to you today. This was short but sweet. Please, when you have some time, like, share, and subscribe. I'm Prophetess Tammy Collins. May the Lord continue to richly bless you and your family. Until next time, stay blessed.